In the wake of every great military is an overwhelming and immeasurable path of destruction, which all too often is overlooked entirely. Evelyn Ralpho, a native Marshall Islander, addressed the group to remind everyone that behind every army, underneath the boots of every great military that we may boast and celebrate, there are multitudes of victims who don't meet the soldiers with ticker tape and marching bands. They meet them with their blood and their lives.
My mother had 7 miscarriages, one which was severely deformed, and then one more died. As bad as the health problem are, recently released documents that the United States scientists conducted human radiation experiments on the Roma beach.
The Marshall Islands were a trust of the American government, and the Marshall Islanders were indeed Americans. The U.S. government conducted nuclear weapons tests on these defenseless Americans for over a decade throughout the 1950s. The impact of these tests was staggering.
Medical experiments are being run. Test animals will be used to enable men of medicine to learn what pressure, heat, and radiation does to living tissue. As an illustration, these mice will be exposed to varying doses of atomic radiation, and medical men will study the results.
Empty hole inside of me as a human. And I'm so glad that we're here together and that we want to work against something like this. because no one deserves to have something like that happen to them. And we talk about statistics, we talk about the technical side, the political side, the military side. Aside from that, it's just the utmost principle of being humans and doing that to each other. That it just defies our existence.
The conference is being held in the belly of the beast. 1,000 miles away, the University of Texas had teamed up with weapons giants Lockheed Martin and Northrop Grumman in the hopes of outbidding the University of California and its partner in arms, Bechtel National, for control of the world's leading nuclear labs in Livermore and Los Alamos. The University of California has managed the Los Alamos laboratory and is responsible for the production of every nuclear weapon in the United States arsenal. However, the government has decided to open up control of the two leading nuclear weapons labs to a bidding war between the UC and the UT, hand in hand with their war profiteers of choice.
This arms race that you're talking about, that is actually between the different branches of the military, is still very much going on right now. Marching, flying, and navigating across the Pacific, and this is like the midway point of imperialism. And I mean, this is a very long-term plan that's going on and playing out right now. Thinking about how huge the base is in Guam, and they're still shooting rockets from California and Kwajalein. I was thinking, as my head started swelling with snot, if only I could lobby as hard as I have to blow my nose right now.
I'm feeling so angry at my history teachers for not making this such a focus of our understanding about what our country is and what it means to be a citizen of this world and everything.
I've always talked about a re-education process for our generation so that we can understand what we just saw in education, but it sounds like we just need an education process.
Realize that we don't have to feel disconnected with one of Marshall Islands is going to have in jail. And downwinders all across the country still are feeling those effects, not just in Nevada, but all over. And
there's everything else. I'm going to take my anger and my pain from it and turn it into something better, something good. It's going to make me, it's going to push me.
No matter how hard you try, you can't stop us now.
A whole bunch of stuff going on because we're in the middle of a campaign right now against our university. We are mass flyering our campus and the lines of our